I'm just kidding.
That's not a good idea.
Oh, my God.
His son is here.
But his son has
Lakshman. His son.
He's represented by his son.
Lakshman.
Yes, Lakshman is
Lakshman.
Here.
Yes.
There he is.
Yes.
He's a Pada?
Yes.
He's a very old disciple of Srila Prabhupada. I want to meet you. I wanted
to meet you.
You have also come? You. Very good. Uddhava, close friend of Pranti Sharkar.
Yes,
and he has also brought one lady who he has introduced to Krishna consciousness. She is Ramona.
Looks like they don't need it.
Sprinkles of mercy. Sprinkles of mercy.
Now I'm okay. But I think you are open. Right? Now you can. Tablet your open. And that's on the hand.
Thank you.
Thank you. Nityananda Parameshwara Vishnupad Paramahamsa Hari Vrajakacharya Astu Tarasita Shri Shimad Habai Charanaravinda Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj Srila Prabhupad
Jai
Om Vishnupad Paramahansa Paribrajakacharya Astu Tarasita Shri Shila Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj
Jai
Nityananda Parameshwara Vishnupad Paramahansa Paribrajakacharya Astu Tarasita Shri Shimad Srila Bhakti Rakshak Sridhar Goswami Maharaj Ki Jai Nityananda Parameshwara Vishnupad Paramahansa Paribrajakacharya Astu Tarasita Shri Srila Gaura Govinda Goswami Maharaj Ki Jai Nityananda All glory to the assembled devotees All glory to Sri Guru and Sri Gauranga
Once again, we are so happy to invite Srila Narayan Maharaj here. I think we are all eternally indebted to him for coming so far, so much austerity to give him, and he is coming to enliven us in Krishna consciousness. I think without this enlivenment, who knows how many births and deaths we may rotate in this material world without the Guru's mercy. In fact, it is hopeless to get out of this material world without the grace of the Guru. It is so rare in this world to find someone who is 100% surrendered to the Supreme Lord, who is unalloyed. It is as rare as finding a touchstone in this world. It is impossible almost. But by Mahaprabhu's mercy, we are getting this very rare and special opportunity to hear about Bhakti Yoga, and especially the innermost stages of Bhakti Yoga. So we are all, we don't know why, but we are all very, very fortunate to have you here. And all the devotees who have come, you are all certainly most welcome to be here. And we'll do everything we can to make you comfortable. And so the festival is going to begin, and it is a great opportunity for all of us to increase our devotional service. And this conference, these gatherings, is fulfilling the purpose of this whole age, is being fulfilled by having these meetings, by chanting the holy name, and congregational chanting. This is the real purpose. This is the real purpose of human life, and we're all very, very fortunate to have them. So I thank all of you, and especially Gurudev, for coming to our humble abode here. Thank you so much.
He's at airport picking up devotees.
Here is the airport?
Bringing devotees coming, more devotees.
Where is the airport?
Fresno.
San Francisco.
Fresno.
You can speak some two words yourself. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Well, it's been a year since Gurudev surprised us by coming up here and grabbing our hearts. And some of us have been fortunate that in that year we got to go to Braj Mandala Parikrama, and we got to go to Navadvip Parikrama. And now we're in New Braj Parikrama. And we can take advantage of the mercy of all these wonderful devotees and Maharaj coming here for those of us that can't go there, and take advantage of making advancement in our spiritual life so that we can serve our Gurudevs more and more, and love Radha and Krishna more and more.
I want to thank
for entering into my life, because about a year ago, for several months, I was crying out somewhere like a voice in the wilderness for help to do the heart work. I tend to approach Krishna consciousness in other ways with my head. And Maharaj, one of the first things he said to me, he said, was, do you think it was your brain that brought you Srila Prabhupada? And it was not my brain that brought me Srila Prabhupada, as he mentioned, it was causeless mercy. And it's also causeless mercy that's brought Srila Narayana Maharaj into my life. And I know many of us here feel the same way. And I want to express my gratitude. We're this tiny little place in the middle of nowhere in the mountains. There's so many major cities and major places, and somehow or other Krishna and his pure devotees have singled us out here. And our lives have never been the same, and they never will be the same. And all glories to Srila Narayana Maharaj, and all glories to causeless mercy. So, Shraddha, faith, is something that all of the Shastras are telling us. If someone is faithful, then they can make advancement on the path of spiritual life. This faith, this Shraddha, is a very rare commodity in this world. It is extremely rare. We have to accumulate so many past credits. Some Sukritis must be there in order for this faith to dawn within the heart. And at the point when this past credits accumulate, where we can have sufficient balance, then we are awarded the Sadhu Sangha. So by this Sadhu Sangha, the faith that we have accumulated also increases, and the quality of that faith also deepens. And we are told that this faith alone can bring us to Krishna. So the devotees, the Vaishnavas, are always praying to the great Vaishnav Thakurs that if you can only award me, just please award me with a drop of faith. Shraddha Bindu Diya. Just please give me a drop of faith. And how do they do this? They shower the nectarine descriptions of the Supreme Lord's Nam, Guna, Rupa, Lila upon the heads of the faithful souls who have come to hear. In the very beginning of our Srila Prabhupada's Srimad Bhagavatam purports, he tells us that one must have submissive oral reception. This term, submissive oral reception, when I first heard this, I began to think, what does this actually mean? But how to become submissive to the words of the great souls? This is not an easy task. One has to have, as I said, accumulated so many pious credits. But one must also get the kripa, the mercy of these Vaishnavas. So they are asking us, please come and associate. Please come and hear. Please come and make your lives perfect by hearing these transcendental pastimes. If we take advantage of this, then surely our lives will be successful. So it is only by their mercy, actually, that we are given this opportunity. If they were not merciful, there would be no chance of us approaching the higher realm. So we must be extremely filled with gratitude and humility, and we must try to take full advantage when we have this great opportunity to hear from such a Vaishnava personality. Now, for the next 2 weeks, we will be able to attend the discourses given by Paramahansa Vaishnava in so rare in this world. And as the previous speakers all said, that we have only Srila Narayan Maharaj himself to thank for coming here to this little place in the middle of the mountains of a foreign land, undergoing so much difficulty also to come. And in this way, if our hearts are very open, we will be able to receive this incredible great gift and treasure that he has come to bestow. So let us bow our heads at his lotus feet and try our very best to hear with complete submissive oral reception. Then our whole heart will be purified and we will be able to actually comprehend what is this Krishna consciousness movement. All glories to Sri Guru and Sri Gauranga.
We want to hear who was very good.
It's nice hearing the devotees express their heart about feeling nowhere. And the sloka of Brahmanda Brahmiti Kalanda Bhagavanji came into my mind now. Really, without the sweet grace of the Lord coming to help us, we're really nowhere. And where there is no love, Vrindavan love, then that's nowhere. And I was thinking how encouraging it is to know that the Supreme Lord is behind all of this. That just beyond the scene, his smiling, beautiful face is there, and he is sending his dear devotees to give us encouragement. If we knew how close he was and how he's orchestrating all these wonderful events in our lives, if we could appreciate so deeply, then surely our spirits would be so high at all times. But in the course of time in my life, I've met two great devotees of the Lord that due to my inability to dive deep into their shiksha, dive deep into their grace, I float to the surface and I become lost and I become totally nowhere. And this was the state of being that I was in for many years after the disappearance of my Gurudev, Srila Sridhar Maharaj and Srila Prabhupada, and then Srila Narayan Maharaj has come to give me great encouragement. And I pray that all the devotees please be merciful to me and help push me deeper and deeper into the shiksha, into the message of what Srila Narayan Maharaj is trying to give into our heart.
Nanda Gopal.
Well, we're also fortunate. 1 year ago, I remember when Srila Gurudev first came and Nirguna stood up and spoke, and the first thing he said is that this is non-sectarian, what you have brought. And that has so much rung true over the past 1 year that my eyes have opened so much in a broad-minded fashion, thanks to the mercy of Srila Narayan Maharaj. Myself, I missed to meet personally Srila Prabhupada by just a few short years. And for so many years, I was wishing and wondering, how was it that I was so unfortunate that I missed Srila Prabhupada? And last year, Srila Narayan Maharaj came, and I feel that this was my special mercy to meet a pure devotee, and that Srila Prabhupada has made this possible, and that Srila Narayan Maharaj is doing this wonderful service for Srila Prabhupada to help us all continue on and be strong in Krishna consciousness. So often, I feel so hopeless, but when we were on the Braj Mandal Parikram, Gurudev many times would say, don't be hopeless, be hopeful. Even though it may seem so difficult, that there's always hope. And one thing Raj Balava Prabhu was just speaking, we read in the Srimad Bhagavatam the other day, where it said that if one has a fortune to meet a pure devotee and obtain a spiritual master, then he has the direct favor of Krishna himself. So we can all feel that Krishna is being very merciful to all of us, that we have this opportunity to serve a pure devotee. And we thank you so much for being here, and we wish to serve you all, Srila Gurudev and everyone who's come, to the best of our ability. Jai.
It's a little over 12 months ago, my Diksha Guru, Srila Gauranga Maharaj, passed away. And after that, I left for my external vision. And I was reading his commentary on Sri Guru Vandana. And he was saying there that after the disappearance of the Guru, the Guru's lotus feet are like a lotus flower. And what causes lotus flower to bloom? The sun. The flower becomes open and gives fragrance and beauty by the shining of the sun. And the Guru's lotus feet are like a lotus flower. And the Guru's lotus feet, they become manifest to the disciple through the intense desire, or the desire within the heart of the sadhaka, to want bhakti. And if that desire is strong within the heart of the sadhaka, then the Guru's lotus feet, like a lotus flower, will become manifest in the heart of the disciple. And even after the disappearance of the Guru, Guru Maharaj mentioned that the Guru keeps a watchful eye on this sadhaka. Even though he may appear not to be present, but he keeps a watchful eye on his disciple. And if the desire for bhakti within the heart of the disciple is very strong, then the Guru will manifest, his lotus feet will become present, and he'll manifest himself before the disciple. And even after the disappearance of the Guru himself, he will arrange, if that sincere desire within the heart of the sadhaka is there for bhakti, the Guru will arrange through another Vaishnava for his instruction and through his deliverance. And I was wondering how this would take place. And I have, after going to see Gurudev in Radhamandal and hearing him speak, seeing him, so much faith in my own Guru Maharaj was strengthened, and I saw how my Guru Maharaj, he spoke, like he was speaking and he stopped on this paragraph and this sentence, and then I met Srila Narayan Maharaj, and then he, just after the full stop, he spoke the next, and he has not stopped since then. He's speaking so wonderfully and so beautifully, and his last tour to Australia, every day I would hear the same siddhant about Guru Tattva, Jiva Tattva, Gora Tattva, and Radha Krishna Lila, and he was, just the next sentence he's speaking on, and I'm just thinking how amazing it is, how wonderful it is. And so my heart is so captured and so indebted, and even though I'm so fallen and so unqualified and so much in need of mercy, I'm so happy that you have come. I'm so happy that I was able to come here. And in the Chaitanya Charitamrita it says there's three very powerful substances: the foot dust of the Guru, his remnants of the Guru, and the water that has washed his lotus feet. And I would like to get a little bag and take a little bit. I'm so much in need of mercy.
She did last time.
She knows some tricks.
She can do sitting more and more, tell you. Money to work.
One thing I've been on, I was reading something very, very special, and it was a prayer that Rupa Goswami wrote about Raghunath Das Goswami, and I don't know Sanskrit very well, and I don't have good memory. But he's praying to Krishna on behalf of Raghunath Das Goswami. And he's saying, I have one friend who's at Radhakuni, who's rolling on the banks of Radhakuni, weeping and weeping. Krishna, please bestow your mercy on this Raghunath Das Goswami, on my friend. Take him out of it. And I was just thinking, how wonderful the deep love of the Vrajabhakti. What friendship they have. And this is what we're all looking for, this kind of loving relationship. And this is what Srila Prabhupada brought us, and this is what Maharaj is bringing us. He's really very fussy. And his deep love is above the game. And we're so grateful.
A few months ago, Gurudev was in Australia, and there was a little book that came out afterwards called Sprinkles of Mercy. Nectar. Same. So this now it's, we feel the mist again, it's coming. Gurudev is here. In the Govinda Lila, Gurudev writes that the young girl was peeking through the doorway, and I believe the mother-in-law tried to stop her and said, don't look at Krishna or you'll get bitten. Well, we all looked, now Gurudev has bitten us. And there's a nice word in English language called smitten. He's taken our hearts. And it's a very, very special thing beyond, we all feel that, we all know that. And he always asks, how are you? We all answer, now we're fine, after seeing you. The spiritual master is such a rare occasion to have such a Vaishnava. And emanating through the heart of such a beautiful servitor of Radha and Krishna, that Haladini Shakti can enter our hearts by his mercy. Otherwise, we are hopeless. So by his grace, we have some hope. And I know you've changed. He has changed many people's lives. He's changed my life. And I think he's going to change the many, many people in the world's lives coming throughout time. My words can't express my gratitude to Srila Gurudev. I wish I can do more, be a better disciple. But by his love, I'm sure my heart, all hearts will change. There's a word called Mukunda Preshta, that the spiritual master is very dear to Lord Mukunda, and he liberates one from the material conception. And the spiritual master is a Radha Priyasaki. He's a confidential servant of Srimati Radhika. And the correlation between Lord Nityananda taking us is very, very unique and beautiful, how Srila Prabhupada brought us the embodiment of Lord Nitya's mercy bringing us. And in Kali Yuga, the associates of Srimati Radhika has associated with Mahaprabhu, the Rai Ramananda, and Sarup Damodar, and intimate in Gaura Lila. So those Gaura Priyasakis were so fortunate to have such a personality in our midst to transmute that Padini Shakti into our hearts. So we pray and thank you really much for all the austerities that you came to come to this area, and all the hardships to be on the airplane and to deal with all those people, and all the stewardesses and everyone else. I know it's hard. It was hard for me. So thank you so much.
I offer my respectful obeisances to the Lotus Feet of my Guru Deva, Srila Prabhupada and Narayana Maharaj, and to all the Acharyas in our line, the Guru Prabhupada Swami, and also all the assembled Vaishnavas. I'm not a very qualified speaker, but I want to express a little bit what happened in England. All the Vaishnavas have said so many beautiful things. How they are so happy to receive Sri Gurudev, and how this gathering will be so auspicious and successful. And traveling with Sri Gurudev is such a wonderful experience. India, we were traveling before India, Australia, Singapore, Bali, and just now we came from England. So in England, Sri Gurudev was speaking on the discussion, the teachings between Narada Muni and Vyasadeva. Narada Muni was indicating to Sri Vyasadeva that he didn't really give that thing which will make everyone supremely happy, or healthy, or even more than that. Vyasadeva was very despondent after writing all the Vedas and Vedic literatures, Puranas. He had outlined so many good instructions for the conditioned soul to make proper advancement. And still he was not feeling happy. So when Sri Gurudev was discussing this, we got tremendous inspiration by his explaining how all the instructions which Vyasadeva had written down, they were actually only helping the living entity to become healthy. Sri Sridhar Maharaj, I believe, has said that he has given the diet for the sick person. And he didn't really give any diet or anything to eat for those who are healthy. So Narada Muni indicated that you have to glorify the pastimes of Sri Krishna in Braja. He associates all the different activities and rasas which are going on there. They are the supreme source of happiness for all living entities. So we are very fortunate because this is the thing which Srila Gurudev wants to give to all. The diet for those who are healthy, yeah, those who want to be healthy, yeah, to hear about the wonderful descriptions of the Braja Lila of Sri Sri Radha and Krishna. This is the real mission of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He has come only for this, to sprinkle the wonderful beauty of the loving exchanges between Srimati Radhika and Krishna and all their eternal associates in Braja. So this is very, as I believe Bhaji Balava Prabhu mentioned, this is very rare, and I realize more and more how Krishna has arranged this for myself, and I believe for all of us. We don't deserve this. We are not in any position to claim that this is to be meant for me. This is sheer mercy which has come our way. And the more and more we are in this association, I feel that this is the most wonderful thing which could ever happen to us in our life. At least I feel more and more that this is something which I hope I will be able to develop the rest of this time in this body, and I wish that so many more can come and share this with us. So I hope that this whole
program in Vajra under the auspicium of Nirgun Prabhu and what is Mula Prakriti Gopa. So many wonderful devotees are living here, so many have come. I think this will be such a successful event that all of us will never be able to forget it. So all glories to all the wonderful Vaishnavas and especially to Sri Gurudev for making his appearance again in New Vrindavan.
Namo Mahavadanaya Krishna Prema Pudaya Tim Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namaya Guru Rakti Sama. Once we were sitting around our Guru Devi Kaliras Ustana Sripas Sri Bhakti Pradyan Kusamaya in our deep mouth. Devananda Gaudiya. So many renowned sannyasi from Haridwar of Advaita Vadi. Very tall figure, very sound hair, very reddish whole body. Very learned persons were there. They came to Paranath and they were sitting with our Guru. They asked that in Haridwar, Rishikesh and other places in Kashi, we have so many big societies, marks, and in each of our temple, mandir, or mart, big gardens are there. Many kinds of flowers are there. But I here, there is no garden, nothing, no rose flowers, no other flowers, Delhi, Chennai and others. Why you don't keep gardens in your mutts? They told that you are not seeing. Very beautiful garden is here. And think that you have no eyes to see these gardens. You are saying that more than 100 Vaishnavas are here, one little boy, young kid. This is my garden. And these are very beautiful flowers, plants. Rose flower only give sent for some distance. But these flowers get sent in whole world. So I think now that wherever I went in Western or Eastern countries, in England, in Holland, in Russia, in Russia, France, Germany, in Western countries, here, Houston, Los Angeles, San Francisco, in Australia, in South America, everywhere there are very beautiful gardens. So I am happy to be in one of the very pure gardens here. You are all the plants of flowers.
that Samiti has lighted with his own hand. I think myself fortunate to obey the orders of Swamiji. That I have planted so many flowers, beautiful creepers everywhere. So you should try to help that my garden should not be dry. If garden is there, so beautiful plants, but no water, then today or after today or some days it will dry. So water is always needed. When it will be very, very big tree, then you cannot give water, but Krishna will give water in rainy season. So no fear for drying. Until they are not matured up to bhav, association, hearing and kirtan, this is like water, it should be good. Otherwise, if it has come to shraddha, it has come to nishtha, ruchi, asakti, even to bhav, if water is not given, then it will draw. When bhav will come, then nothing worry, that the friends will try. So up to that time, we should try to be associated with very bona fide Krishna. In the line of our Gurudev, I have so much affection for my Gurudev. And he can give nectar in the same line of Harikatha. So Swamiji Maharaj, in his last days, he ordered me that, yes sir, help my devotees. Also my Gurudev ordered me to preach, to write books, periodical magazines and everything. So I wanted to preach and write and go everywhere, but I was not qualified. I've never dreamt that I will come to America, I will come to this place, I will go to Australia, Singapore, Malaysia, in South America, here and there, in Africa. But I don't know how he managed. I think that Krishna himself, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Swamiji, is making all arrangements for me. Especially I am happy. Mostly I am happy that wherever I go, I see that so many senior and sincere devotees of Swamiji himself, enjoying everything. When I went in Australia, so many senior devotees of Swamiji helped me so much that I was so much happy. I was melted, my heart was melted. When I came here, some persons told that you should not host Narayan Maharaj anywhere in England or America or anywhere. But Swamiji arranged. So I am so much indebted to my Shiksha Guru, Shri Swami Maharaj, that he personally inspired devotees to help me. Because I have not come for my self-gain, nothing, only to follow the orders, carry the orders of my Guru.
Guru Bhargava, Siksha Guru, Diksha Guru, and all of us. I have nothing to them. But I think that if I may help devotees who are neglected, who have no means to be associated and no means to develop their Krishna consciousness, pure devotion of Krishna, which please Krishna, then there will be joy. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur has told that in this world, pure bhakti is very rare. I think that very rare person will know what is pure devotion. He has written so much in Jaiva Dharma and so everywhere in the explanation of Chaitanya Charitamrita, Amrit Pravah Bhashya, perhaps you know, he has written so many articles. A very little book is Tattva Vivek, very good book. You should try to read it. What is pure? The cultivation of activities solely for the benefit of Krishna or for Krishna or for the devotees of Krishna. So please only do that. Not polluted with any kind of jnana, karma, yoga, tapasya, anything. Now everywhere in the world, especially in India, they tell that we are following pure Krishna bhakti. But Srila Prabhupada told that in all world which is going in the name of pure bhakti is not pure. All are polluted. Mishra bhakti. Contaminated.
Mixed.
So it is very, very, very important to give this pure bhakti to all world. They told what I told in England, my class, that Vasudev has divided 4 Vedas. He has written Vedanta Sutra. He has written Mahabharata. All the Purans, everything. He has spread all kinds of knowledge, what is Jiva Tattva, Maya Tattva, Krishna, and all other thoughts. But he was not satisfied. There will be no supreme anything, Tattva, that he has expressed in Vedanta Sutra. All acharyas have explained this. Without explaining, anyone cannot be a church. But even he has did this, he was not happy. Why? He had not explained the glories of gopis, the Prajavasi. To glorify Krishna, it is essential to glorify his mother, Nanda Yashoda, his friend, Sridham Subhasaka, and mostly, prominently, the glories of gopis, to whom Krishna was indebted. And he was telling, Napareham Nirvadyasamya. I cannot repay gopis.
was given their hearts, their husband, their all kinds of religion, even shyness, loka dharma, everything. There's no example of any so pure devotee like gopis. Krishna has repaid all, but not gopis. So Narada Rishi is telling him that you have not bullied five gopis pain. Radha pain. Who is Srimati Radhika? Who are gopis? Who is Nanda Yashoda and all? So you do it. And then you will be happy. Then by bhakti, yoga, you show all these things as if they were in the hands by bhakti. Everything. And then you will be here. For all the persons to be here. So I've been trying by Srimad Bhagavatam and Kanto and by Chaitanya Charitamrita regular classes as we did in Australia Chaitanya Charitamrita third and fourth special chapters. So here we will try to discuss all these things so that you can easily develop your Krishna consciousness. Perhaps from tomorrow, our classes will begin in the evening. In the evening, you will see it.
Yes, well, I think we'll have a lot more devotees, so we'll have the classes in the pavilion that we have built.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, right near our house here, 100 yards, 100 meters, there's a pavilion we have constructed
let
for
them
this.
All come?
Yes.
And then
we want to show you.
So from tomorrow we will begin the classes, prepare everything. In the name of all Swamiji, to please Swamiji and Krishna and my guru. And thus people will be able to understand what is pure bhakti, Krishna prem, Braja bhakti. We will take rest and we have come 5 hours.
I'm
feeling so much happy to be among you. So many devotees coming from Australia, very hungry and thirsty for our Krishna Bhakti nectar. I'll be happy to be among and I will be inspired by the Lord. So thanks, so many thanks to you all.
You brought some new publication from Sri Bhaktivinoda Vijay and Pinnacle of Devotion, Lectures from Australia also, Unnatural Rasa, and Internal Relationship, the relationship between Swami Prabhupada and Sri Maharaja. They will all come today and tomorrow, so in the hours that we cannot go to the source in the Guru Dev, we can read.
Okay. Four at 1 o'clock.
1 o'clock.
So in 10 or 15 minutes there'll be lunch over in the pavilion over there that we have constructed. So
I have something inside.
Still? Open the car, it's closed.
I took everything out.
Something? Camera. Something?
I want
to use one.
Yes.
Jaya Guru Deva.
Because it is a little larger and it has its own bathroom. The daughters have arranged everything.
What car was open?
Yes. I hope the car was closed.
Why do you think it is closed?
So we met last time.